classes in the minbar. Up until barakallah fikum, they will do it. We will not cease to alhamdulillah to make our voice clear about this issue of the maulud. And this is our responsibility, barakallah fikum. So fabashirhum bi'adhabin aleem. Then give them the glad tidings of the severe punishment that is awaiting for them. وَكَذَلِكَ مَنْ قَامَ فِي وَجْهِ الْحَقِّ. And those who want to be obstacle upon the haqq, they want to block the truth. Wallahi, you got individual, they want to block the truth. يُرِيدُونَ لِيُطْفِئُوا نُورَ اللَّهِ. They want to cover the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has guaranteed it. It doesn't matter what do they say about the people of the sunnah. And now this is the same individual, they say, oh, now everything is bid'ah, everything is haram. That's the same statement from this individual bisek. Oh, now everything is bid'ah, everything is haram now. Now making mockery of the religion. قُلْ أَبِاللَّهِ وَآيَاتِهِ وَرُسُلِي كُنْتُمْ تَسْتَهْزِئُونَ لَا تَعْتَذِرُوا قَدْ كَفَرْتُمْ بَعْدَ إِيمَانِكُمْ. That you have disbelief after your belief. You making mockery of the religion of Allah? Oh, now everything is haram. Oh, now everything is bid'ah. Are you making mockery of the deen of Allah subhanahu? You making mockery of the people of the sunnah wal-iyadhu billah. And you having enmity with the people that are calling to the truth. The shahafidhahu Allah, he say, وَقَتُلُ الدُّعَاء إِلَى اللَّهِ وَقَتُلُ الدُّعَاءَ إِلَى اللَّهِ. And killing those who are calling to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. والآمرين بالمعروف, those who are enjoying the good, والناهين عن المنكر, and those who are, they are يعني enjoying the good and they are يعني prohibiting, and that which is prohibiting the evil, they enjoying the good and they forbidding the evil. He say فإن الآية الكريمة تتناوله. This verse, it also بارك الله فيكم carry this meaning. It also carry this meaning, meaning those who they have enmity for those who are enjoying the good and forbidding the evil. Enjoying the good and forbidding the evil. طيب. شصار فوضان حفظه الله وانت سي لأنه سلك مسلكة أهل الجاهلية. لأنه سلك مسلكة أهل الجاهلية. Because this individual that is having this enmity with the people of the truth, he has embarked, he has traversed, or he is traversing, he has taken the path of the people of Jahiliyyah. He has taken the path of the people of Jahiliyyah. So therefore, فَيَكُونُ حُكُمُهُ كَحُكُمِهِمْ. So therefore, the ruling of the people of Jahiliyyah would be his ruling. The ruling, or his ruling, would be the same as the ruling of the people of Jahiliyyah. So we should not, barakallahu fikum, have any enmity with the people of the truth. We shouldn't have any enmity with the people of the truth whatsoever. المسألة الحادية عشرة بعد المئة 111. الإيمان بالباطل. Believing in falsehood. Believing in falsehood. Believing in falsehood. This is the aspect number 111. قال تبارك الإيمان بالجبت والتاغوت. الإيمان بالجبت والتاغوت. قال تبارك وتعالى سورة النساء verse number 51. قال الله تعالى ألم ترى إلى الذين أوتوا نصيبا من الكتاب يؤمنون بالجبت والتاغوت. Haven't you seen those who have been given a portion of the book? They have been given the portion of the book. يؤمنون بالجبت والتاغوت. They believe in الجبت and the تاغوت. شصال الفوضان حفظه الله سي والجبت قيل هو السحر. الجبت قيل هو السحر. And we will read inshallah a few narration in regard to this tafsir, and that shows barakallahu fikum that the ilm, I mean in the Quran, it has to be barakallahu fikum taken from the understanding of the sahaba. Alam tara ila alladhina utu nasiban min alkitabi yu'minuna biljibt. Qala Umar radiyallahu anhu wa arda aljibt as-sihr. That's why Sheikh Fawzan hafizahullah mentioned qila aljibt huwa as-sihr wa qila ash-shaytan wa qila ash-shaytan. But let us read inshallah in more details few narration in regard to the statement of aljibt, the word aljibt, because the word aljibt, where there is a combination between a jim and a ta, that this is a word that is not commonly an Arabic word. A word that has a jim in the beginning and a ta at the end. It is not commonly an Arabic word. For instance, the word jahannama. Jahannama aslan. Sheikh Salih Uthaymeen rahimahullah say it is not an Arabic word. But rather it is a Persian word, meaning it is taken from a Persian word. Kahannama. Kahannama. This is the Persian word kahannama. That barakallahu fikum in the with the Arabs. So the asr of this word is a Persian word. It's not an Arabic word. For instance, you have in some of our local languages a word where the asr of it is not from the language. Huh? It could be Latin. Very good. Let's say, give me an English word that is the origin of it is not an English word. Like very good. Renaissance. Renaissance is not an English. Voila. Déjà vu. This is not an English word. It's a French word. And you have in, I'm very sure, in your language, you got certain words that is not from your language. It is taken from another language. And now so people use it so much so that they would think it's part of the language. So the word jibt, it is not barakallahu fikum an Arabic word, but it is understood, walhamdulillah. So here he mentioned the statement of Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu. Upon hearing this verse, he mentioned, أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا نَصِيبًا مِنَ الْكِتَابِ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْجِبْتِ قَالَ عُمَرْ ibn al-Khattab, الْجِبْتِ as-sihr. So the word jibt is as-sihr. وَرُوِيَ مَعَنَاهُ عَنْ أَبُو عَالِيَةِ وَمُجَاهِدْ. So this wording or the meaning of as-sihr here, al-jibt to mean sihr, it has been, barakallahu fikum, taken from Umar ibn al-Khattab on the authority of al-Abu Aliya, Mujahid, fi riwayatin, also in another riwayat of Ikrima, wa'ata ibn Abi Rabaha, wa'ata al-Sakhrani, wa'ata al-Sakhrani. And likewise was Sa'id ibn Jubair, and likewise Sa'id ibn Jubair. قال ابن عباس رضي الله عنه الله أكبر أجبت الشيطان أجبت الشيطان. And this is the same statement that Sheikh Salih Fawzan mentioned. He say قيل هو السحر وقيل الشيطان. So we wanted to know who say who or who say what. So the one that say الجبت meaning سحر is Umar ibn Khattab radiyallahu anhu. And the one that say it is a shaitan is Ibn Abbas, Abdullah ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhu wa arda. So he mentioned alaykum as-salam wa barakatuh. Wa qala Ibn Abbas, and likewise in another narration from Ibn Abbas fi riwayati Ali ibn Abi Talha al-jibt al-shirk al-jibt al-shirk. On another riwayah of Ibn Abbas, on the authority of Ali ibn Abi Talha, he say al-jibt is al-shirk. So another statement of Ibn Abbas also is that al-jibt is al-shirk. Is al-shirk. وَقَالَ فِي رِوَايَةِ الْعَوْفَيْنِ وَقَالَ فِي الرِّوَايَةِ عَوْفَيْنِ الْجِبْتْ الْأَصْنَامِ الْجِبْتْ الْأَصْنَامِ. طيب وَقَالَ فِي رِوَايَةِ العوفين الجبت هي الأصنام. So likewise the statement of Ibn Abbas that we find that he mentioned الجبت it mean the shaitan, الجبت it mean also الشرك, and الجبت it mean also الأصنام the idols. And all of this barakallahu fikum, it is upon one concept, the concept of what? Shirk. Right? All of them fall down to الشرك بارك الله فيكم. وقال الشعبي في رواية وسعيد ابن جبير والضحاك ويحيى ابن أبي كثير الجبت الكاهن. الجبت الكاهن. الكاهن is the sorcerer. It goes back to the sihr. It goes back to the sihr. It goes back to the asnam. It goes back to the shaitan. طيب. Now,
what verse was that?
Surah An-Nisa, verse number 51. Last one, يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْجِبْتِ وَالْتَاغُوتِ. And this is very important, inshallah ta'ala. وَقَالَ قَالَ فِي رِوَايَةِ عَلِي إِبْنِ أَبِي طَلْحَ عَنْ إِبْنِ عَبَّاسِ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ عَنْهُمَا قَالَ التَّاغُوتِ كَعْبُ ابن الأشرف. التاغوت كعب ابن الأشرف. التاغوت كعب ابن الأشرف. And we have read Barakal in the book that is Nawaqid al-Islam with the explanation of Sheikh Fawzan Hafidhullah, where he brought the qissa of the statement of كعب ابن الأشرف. Right? كعب ابن الأشرف. And كعب ابن الأشرف كان يهودي. كان يهودي ويأخذ ويأخذ إيش الغشوة. He used to take bribery. He was a Yahud and he used to take bribery, right? يريدون أن يتحاكموا إلى التاغوت وقد أمروا أن يكفروا به. And this was in regard to كعب ابن الأشرف, because there was this منافق, right, الذين يزعمون أنهم آمنوا, those who pretended that they believe, meaning the منافقين, right. He had a issue with a Yahudi أصلا. So the Yahudi told him, نأتي إلى محمد. Let's go to Muhammad so he will give the judgment between our affairs. But the munafiq, he tell him, no. نذهب إلى كعب ابن الأشرف. لماذا؟ لأنه يأخذ الرشوة. Because the munafiq knew that كعب ابن الأشرف, he will take bribery. And this is why he was named التاغوت. يريدون أن يتحاكموا إلى التاغوت. إلى من؟ إلى كعب ابن الأشرف. This is why, barakallahu feekum, from this riwayah of Ali ibn Abi Talha radiyallahu anhu, an ibn Abbas radiyallahu anhuma, qala at-taghut Ka'b ibn al-Ashraf. He say, rajulun min al-kuffar kana yu'zi an-nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Along with that, he was taking bribery. Kana yu'zi ala an-nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yu'zi an-nabi, he used to harm the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He used to harm the messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam. And likewise, وقال في رواية العوفيني التاغوت الذي يكون بين يدي الأصنام. A taghut is the one that, the individual that is in front of the idols. Meaning the one that will be in between the idols and the people. طيب. He is the one that is between, and he is in charge of the asnam. In other words, he is the kahin. Right? He is the magician and the likes of this. He say, يَعْتَبِرُونَ عَنْهَا الْكَذِبِ. And he will be, barakallahu feekum, saying that this is what the asnam say. This is what the idols say. Or this is what the idols say. لِيُضِلَّ النَّاسِ. To just misguide the people. Right? So likewise, this individual is called the taghut. وقال جابر ابن عبد الله رضي الله عنه التاغوت. He say, أو التواغيت. He made the جمع. التواغيت هم الكهان. Right? The taghut, they are the magicians or the sorcerers. طيب. He say, تنزل عليهم الشياطين. Unto whom the shayateen they will descend.